So is this a rubbish time to call you? Yeah. Okay, no, it's fine. I just thought it... No, I only set off at 7 minutes past three. Yeah, as I said, I finished last night. As usual, well, it takes me quite a while to get out and sort of blah, 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 so. Well, listen, we can speak some other time. I just thought I wasn't sure if it was a good time to call, but as I said, you can go and attend to your guests. My mum would have thought you were fat. She would. You are actually quite a lot. I don't like it. She might not love you. No, it's, No, as I said, well, my mum was great, but it's just the things that you do. You go out of your way to do things and make things well. I do think that you do very well. Listen, I'm going to let you go and do whatever you want to. If you want to chat, give me a call. I've got 3 minutes, all right? I can come back. I'll probably get to Yolster about 9:30, 10-ish, something like that. So, God bless you. I'm driving very gently. I'm actually videoing the journey. Yeah. I've got my seatbelt now. I've got my seatbelt on. I'm driving very sedately. I'm doing 80, just over 80 kilometres an hour. And I've got a video camera on the dashboard. I'm videoing the trip. Yeah, it's the kind of thing. I don't know. You see, until you video something and upload it to YouTube, you have no idea how many hits it will get. You know, some people might think, oh, driving around Norway in September, you know, all some colours and stuff. You might see. Is this in Norway? Really? That sounds a bit cruel. That I couldn't. It's not something I've. No, I've. I mean, really, I suppose I should just try and become a cabaret actor. That's what I should do. I did have an idea. You know, some musicians, they can't work unless they've got the words in front of them. They either can't remember the words or they never bother committing them to memory. And I mean, everything I do with the words are in my head, so I don't have anything like that. But I just thought it could be quite a good laugh. You know these work lights that all sportsmen have that strap to your forehead? I just thought it could be a great part of my act, because I'm of a certain age and so my eyesight is going good, and I'm not very good with glasses. I can't find the right glasses for being able to see the keyboard and to be able to see the words. So I've just thought that part of the act could be just to be hysterically like moving away from the piano, moving close to the piano, and also have one of these illuminated, have a magnifying glass on a stand, and one of these lamps on my head. So I'm basically there, I've got these work lights attached to my head, a big magnifying glass on the piano, the lyrics at the other end of the piano, and I'm just trying to get everything just right. And I can probably waste ages talking about the physics of magnifying images, and I could have a tape measure. Yes, exactly. And then I can sing some really poignant ballads. Yes, yeah. I keep on looking at the audience with this light flashing around there. Now, do you see what I mean? I mean, a bit like Victor Borge, because I mean, Victor Borge got to the stage where he never touched the piano and he never sang, he never did anything. Because everything was just the preamble to everything was like a pretext not to play the piano, you know. That's yeah. It's the same with the lyrics as well. Morgan and Wise. Yeah, and I think they did had it with Andre Previn. And they called, no, they kept on calling him, was it Andrew Previn or Andrew Preview? Andrew Preview. Do you ever remember a singer called Des O'Connor? Okay. Yeah, well, you remember Morgan and Wise were always making fun of Des O'Connor. Right. Well, there was a great, I mean, they were making so much fun of Des O'Connor that eventually the tabloids started speculating that there was a feud between Morgan and Wise and Des O'Connor. And there was a really brilliant gag, is that Morgan and Wise once started off their show, and so before we get into the show, there's been some speculation in the media that Des O'Connor and I are not the best of friends. And Eric Morgan said, I'll have you know that Des O'Connor came to my daughter's wedding. He wasn't invited, but he came. It's just fabulous script writing, yeah, and it was just brilliant. Brilliant writing. And of course, you know, Christmas was complete without listening to the, you know, what? I think more people watched Morgan and Wise than watched the Queen's speech, so. Really? They never. Is that your stepdad? Right. Your father. Oh, God. Yeah. Yeah. Well, Daniel and I got into Clouseau very early. And I am glad that, I mean, at least Daniel and I did manage to spend enough time together for us to have some nice memories to look back on. So, and the few things that we associate together. Yes. Yeah, no, I think it's a great thing to do on a Christmas day, you know, and just to like, just sit down and say, right, you know, start your own family tradition, right, we're going to watch Revenge of the Pink Panther, or, yes, and, oh God, and whenever they were trying to get into the Stot, Daniel thought that was just hilarious, you know, and, fabulous, absolutely. Listen, I'm going to let you go because I don't want to keep you from your guests. So I just thought it was worth the point. Have a lovely day, all right? And I'm sure I'll do my best, all right? I love you. God bless you. Bye. Thank you.